But I thought that I would add a little bit of narration to this Lake Powell vacation video. So on this trip with us, we have the Robert Allen. We have his lovely wife, Angela Allen. Christian Criswell, aka The Shredder. Jordan Allen. Britton Allen, Jordan's wife, aka Great Britton. We have Brennan Rogers. We have Tyler Allen, he's mine. And Jaker. I don't know your last name, Jake, I'm really sorry. So when you get to Lake Powell, the first step is to find the camping spot. The place that we camped was called Gunsight. Robert and Angie drove the houseboat to the camping spot. There is 3 bedrooms and 2 bathrooms, and a nice big living room and kitchen area. That thing goes like 10 miles per hour.
I don't think it ever went that fast. I think his dad screenshotted the average miles per hour and it was like 7.8. And when you're trying to get to a campground that's like 20 miles away, that's personal.
And then the rest of us took the other 2 boats. We had all the luggage and all the food. Then once you get to your camping spot, you have to park the houseboat, which is not as easy as it sounds because it's a big boat. Stake some giant metal stakes into the ground, tie some ropes to them, and tighten the boat into the shore. Every once in a while, they'll open the dam up and the water level of the whole lake will go down about a foot. So then you have to undo all the ropes. You have to back the boat up and then re-tighten the ropes.
Also, the houseboat is heavy, so trying to tighten those ropes took some serious muscles.
Serious muscles.
And Robert brought 2 of his boats. One of them is a Cobalt, I don't know much about it, but it's a big 27-footer yacht-rated boat. We take the ski boat, which is Mastercraft. So we'll take that out in the mornings and we'll go wakeboarding and surfing and skiing. And then once the water starts to get a little bit rougher, we'll take out the Cobalt and cruise around the lake. We did some cliff jumping, and by we, I mean all the boys did some cliff jumping. I don't do cliff jumping. There's something about flailing 30 feet through the air and hitting water that feels like concrete.
That
just doesn't appeal to me. It's just not fun to me. But I think that there's kind of like a form, something about you have to point your toes and keep your arms to your sides. I don't know, and supposedly it hurts less.
1, 2, 1. Jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. Summer nights, love them, why they take so long. Run with the feeling of being alive while we're jumping on the porch like mom's not home. Just a couple kids living on our own. Summer nights.
So the houseboat that we're staying on is a pretty decent sized houseboat, but there are some incredible houseboats out there, especially at Antelope Point, which is one of the little marinas that we go to. They have some houseboats that are parked out over there that are absolutely incredible. Probably costs about $20,000 a week to rent one of those things.
So there we were at Lake Powell, and on the first day we had sun, and on the second day we had sun, and on the third day we had a storm. For anybody that hasn't been to Lake Powell, let's just tell you real quick how big the lake is. It's massive.
It's not a normal lake.
It's not a normal lake. It's like a Grand Canyon that they filled with water. And it is approximately 190 miles long. if you added up the entire shoreline of the lake, it equals over 2,000 miles, which is longer than if you took the entire Pacific shoreline of the United States.
It took them 20 years to fill it to capacity. I think they filled it up with like 300 feet of water or something like that. And that was the highest that it ever was 1983. If you look in the videos and the pictures and stuff, you'll kind of see like what they call the bathtub ring. That's kind of that white part of the rock that's around there. And that's the height that it was in 1983.
It's gone down 80 feet since it was initially filled all the way to the top, which is only about 57% of what it used to be. So there we were. We had just stopped at the Dangling Rope Marina. We just stopped there to get some root beer floats, some gas in the boat, and some ice. We started heading back towards our camp. As we got closer, we started to notice some clouds forming above. And then the rain started. But when you have 35 mile per hour winds coming at you and you are driving like 30 miles per hour into the wind, it feels like hail. And we turn a corner and we just see this wall of white and the rain is just pouring and there's like a definite line in the lake from where the storm starts and where we are. And it's moving towards us, but the water where the storm was hitting, we don't know how big the waves were because we didn't dare head over there. I think that after the fact, we were told that the swells were probably 8 feet in a lake. And we're in a pretty big boat. It's a yacht rated boat. So we're sitting there debating if we want to just go through or not. Because at this point, we're probably 5-10 miles from our camp. We're probably 15 miles to head back to Dangling Rope. We are very unprepared. None of us are wearing life jackets. We have life jackets, but none of us are wearing them. We start coming around some more corners and we see another wall of just white rain coming towards us. So we kind of start to figure we're in the eye of the storm because it's pretty calm where we're at. And we're looking ahead of us, and we're looking behind us. We decide that the storm in front of us is a little bit less life-threatening than the storm behind us. And then the lightning starts. I don't really know what happens when you're in a boat and lightning strikes the water next to you, but I can't imagine that it's good. We start heading into the less threatening storm. Lightning starts striking. It's still like a couple of miles ahead of us, so we're not too concerned about it. And then suddenly, lightning strikes. The cliff next to us, that's probably the closest I've ever been in my life to lightning. But we just keep powering through because at this point, we don't really have a choice. It's either go back into the storm or go forward into the storm. And to give you another idea of how bad this storm is, there were docks being ripped apart. There were a couple houseboats that we passed that had been completely blown into shore. Beached horizontally into the shore, which that's a disaster when that happened. And Tyler's dad, Robert, has been going to Lake Powell for about 30 years. He says that this is the worst storm he's ever seen on the lake. So, we got to Dangling Rope safely. We waited out the storm. And Angie was kind enough to buy us all ponchos. Put on our ponchos, we put on our life jackets, and we got back in the boat. And not a single drop of rain was felt on the way back. But we were prepared. Then we got back to our camp and lived happily ever after.
Oh,
definitely highly suggest you put it on your bucket list, because I would say it's probably one of the prettiest lakes in the entire world.